on behalf of this party, say how grateful we are for your support here today and for your continued support over the long years since the formation of this party for the ideals of Guyana, for freedom in our country, and for progress. And have no doubt about it that this party's long track record has been one in service of the people of this country, has always been from the time it was established by Chedi Jagan, and that it will continue to do so. We are not just trying to win an election, we are fighting for an ideal that was established when this party was formed, that all the people of Guyana, regardless of their race and their religion, must live a decent, prosperous life, that we must work, be patriotic, we must work very hard to ensure that every single day we move our country forward. And if you follow the periods when we have been in office as PPP, you will see that we have remained faithful to that ideal, notwithstanding all the problems, because there were many problems along the path to progress. Chedi Jagan faced them in and out of government, and we faced them too when we tried to develop Guyana. You know how it was in 1992. We came into government with nothing practically to start our development. The country was declared uncreditworthy. We couldn't borrow because they had borrowed so much that debt, the debt burden alone took up, to service that burden, took up more than 1.5 times total revenue of this country. The roads here were non-existent. Sea defenses on the Essequibo coast. I remember the early days, coming here with Fazal Ali for the first time. First political meeting I spoke at was at Aurora. And I recall how it was in those days. And many of you have lived through that, the older folks. The younger ones don't know because they grew up under the PPP. And then we worked very hard to change this country so that by the time we left office, Guyana had the most vibrant economy in the Caribbean. That our economy grew from $300 million to over $3 billion. That the debt burden was practically written off. That you had schools and hospitals here on the coast and a decent road to drive on. And that Amerindians who were neglected all across this country, that they too had progress, saw progress in Guyana. And even places like Linden, tomorrow we are going to Linden, we work hard on housing schemes so that people there could have a place to live in and to create jobs, etc. Because that's the very nature of the People's Progressive Party. And what we are fighting, I said against, is a different ideal, a total contrast to the PPP. On their side, they believe they have a right to rule. Granger said he was born to rule in Linden. Nobody is born to rule. You're not a king. You're not a king. You don't have a monarchy in Guyana. You have to work hard to get people's confidence so that they will support you. That's when you run governments. And you know why? We can, on a day like today, a Saturday, come here and at 3 o'clock in the afternoon have a crowd of people without bringing foreign artists to perform here, is because we have a track record of progress. They can't do that. People come here because of their love for the party and because we have something to speak about. They can't do that. They will never be able to hold a crowd at this time of the day on the basis of their achievements. So last night in Linden, single thing in that community to create jobs for people. So here on the Essequibo Coast and in the rice industry, you've seen that neglect. The fishermen too, some of them met me there, and it is because of the incompetence of this government that many of them have difficulties now. Because of their incompetence when the United States placed a ban on catfish going into the U.S. But right across Guyana, people have felt the brunt of their policies. They've increased taxes by $88 billion more per year. That's coming from your pockets. They've borrowed $900 million. They've spent nearly $1.2 trillion of our money. Yet rice is in trouble. Sugar is in trouble. Bauxite is in trouble. Gold, we lost thousands of jobs in the gold mining sector. Forestry, we're producing half of what we were producing in the past. And on the other hand, they've been busy dismantling welfare. And this is what the philosophy, what you are fighting against is a philosophy of profligacy, where they spend taxpayers' money at will on things that will not change people's lives. So these elections are crucial. It's not just about winning the elections. It's about what kind of policy you practice. And there is one thing that we are clear about, the PPP has clarity of vision on, is what we will do from day one. What we will do from day one. And we have been explaining this right across the country. So today, I heard Mark said that they'll be putting out a manifesto. We have put out the key elements of our manifesto already, and it has very specific, believable initiatives because we have costed everything. But when they put out their manifesto, they will promise everything under the sun again. But who will believe them? Who will believe them? They're totally untrustworthy. If you broke every single promise to every group of persons in this country from 2015, to the pensioners, the children of Guyana, university education, the rice farmers, the miners, every group, the soldiers, they took away their bonus, the policemen and the others. They broke their promises to the public servant. And by the way, I heard there's an REO here who has threatened the staff if they come to the meeting that they're going to fire him. Like his time is limited there. In another 40-something days, he's gone. We don't believe in threatening people. All of these useless cronies that they have walking around the place, the little gods, time of little gods are gone from March 2nd. We got to get back to work. So comrades, this is what the PPP is about. This is what you're voting against. You're voting against bullyism. Bullyism. Look at our flags going up here. And at Dartmouth, it's not the people of Dartmouth who took down our flags. It's APNU who sent people there to knock them down, some of them told me. They're desperate, but flags don't win elections, although we have a lot of flags. Votes do. Votes do. And we have the votes on our side. They're getting desperate by the day. Harmon and Valda Lawrence are fighting each other now for who will be opposition leader. I'm losing my job on March 2nd. I'm losing my job on March 2nd because one of them will be opposition leader. And thankfully, because comrades, the journey has been a rough one. I recall in 2015, just before elections across there at State House, I came here and I sat, the rice farmers there, about 500 of them came to that meeting. And they were all telling me about this $9,000 a bag and how the PPP took the Petro-Caribbean money and used it up, and it came in for the rice farmers. And I said to them, no, you have it wrong. You have it wrong. Many still believe that because they thought the people who brought the message this message were credible people like Nagamutu and Ramjetan and some of their local stooges. Is private business. Well, from March 3rd, it becomes government business once again. Government business once again. And I see all of these small parties. You have a ton of them who will be on the ballot paper now. You didn't see them when this battle was there, and we had to fight a long, hard battle against APNU, or else it would have been worse now. We would have lost more than 30,000 jobs had we not fought them in Parliament or protested against them. Imagine when they put the VAT on education. It was our fight that we led that managed to get them to remove the VAT. When they increased the tributary tax by 100% and they increased the 2% final tax for the miners to 28%. It's the PPP who led the fight. When they were denying the Amerindian community's basics, we led the fight against the firing of so 2,000 Amerindians. We wrote the United Nations. We have been in the forefront, your party, of the struggle for the last several years, or it would have been worse. They would have taken more advantage. They would have been more corrupt because we've been exposing them every single day. And they have no shame. Imagine, couple days before elections, they're planning to give out forestry leases now. Absolutely no shame. And they talk about decency in this government. So comrades, the fight has to go on. But we knew this day will come. We're not fair weather friends. Immediately after the government change, we came back on the Essequibo coast. And we've been visiting, and we've been talking to people, and we knew this day will come. The day for the people of Guyana, and the day for Essequibans once again will come. A day that we must all look forward to, because that's the day when we save our country, not only for PPP people, but for all the people of Guyana. So comrades, I must say a couple of things. You know, Granger left for Cuba yesterday. So guess what we have now? We have an inanimate object as president, a rubber stamp. Imagine Nagamutu, the rubber stamp, today is president. They're panicked. Nagamutu is sad. He's doing his last rungs now. Ramjetan is totally useless. The arrogance of this man. They took him to Linden to talk about, you know, inclusiveness. And he was the one who said, he shut down the tongue in Linden at 2 a.m. And then he said, if you talk too much, I'd shut it down at 12 o'clock in the night. This sort of thing, useless, can't solve crime, just filling their pockets and squatting on government. Well, we're going to end that squatting. That's the squatting. We're going to legalize the tenure and put it for that illegally. Squatting. Comrades, imagine they spent over $600 million on medical bills for people in the cabinet, and we can't find insulin in the hospital here, or basic drugs in some of the hinterland locations. They don't even have Panadol, but they spent over $600 million on medical plans. You know, the taxpayers pay for them to go to Ireland and everywhere else. That is what we're doing. They put a restriction on vehicles, push up the cost of vehicles over 8 years old. They ban used tires, but they didn't have to travel with you, an old vehicle, etc., because Jordan got GRA to sell his son and a member of his family two vehicles each for $250,000. And they have 300 others who have done this. I heard Jordan was here last night. He's hiding from his record. Comrades, and then in the office of the president alone, they bought 44 new vehicles, spent nearly $500 million only in that ministry whilst they're putting pressure on people. The $1.6 billion grant that from the children, they took that away, but they increased food in government by $1.6 billion. It tells you about the nature of this government. They are up to no good. They're not good for our country. They're bad for democracy. They're bad for freedom. They're bad for development. And we have to get them out on March 2nd. Comrades, I'm not going to speak much longer, because we need to listen carefully to our presidential candidate outline our vision for this country. It's clear. It starts from day one. The hard work starts to reverse the decline that started under them. Don't be provoked. Don't worry with these small parties. They came, they never fought all these years. You know why many of these small parties were formed? Because they saw a man named Keith Scott. Keith Scott got a party. Keith Scott is the president of the party. He's the general secretary. He's the member of the party, a one-man party. So he joined up in this coalition with APNU. And guess what? He got a job as a minister. Now he getting $1 million a month, his salary, which they increase. He got vehicles. He got TSU guarding him now. Keith Scott used to kick brick on the road. And Keith Scott now got all his perks and fancy things. So all of these parties now, they think, well, boy, if we get a couple of votes, we could link up with APNU. We could link up with APNU and get a ministerial position. They'll come with all their lies again. And some of them are just from here, Essequibo Coast. So when they come, give them the silent treatment. Don't go to their meetings. Ignore them totally. This is a free country. They can form parties. But you are free to not to vote for them. And I know you will not. So comrades, be careful. We have to do this. single individual who should make any excuse on March 2nd. If they got to go to the back dam to check the rice, then fetch them to the back dam and fetch them out back. Make sure they come out or get up early. We got to wrap this up by 10 o'clock. By 10 o'clock, we got to wrap this up, this region. Because trust me, they tried to tamper with the voters list. We fought it off when they wanted to go to the house registration. Every single day they will try something new, but we are vigilant. We're watching them. We're not a party that was formed yesterday. We're looking at everything. And as we thwart them, they get more desperate. So you have your role to play. And you can't beat one thing. You can't beat the vote. And every one of you have that power in your hands. So make sure that you, your family, friends, every single person in this region goes out on that day. So much is at stake. So much is at stake. Comrades, we will give this government $10 billion. We will give them $10 billion of oil money. And we'd still be worse off than Venezuela. And you know, many of you know what is happening over there. People don't have food. They were exporting 3 million barrels of oil a day. We're going to produce 120,000 barrels a day. They were exporting 3 million barrels a day, and they don't have food. And many of our people had to run away back to Guyana. And we have to find a way of accommodating them too in the future and helping them to reintegrate our people who are coming back, as well as find jobs for those who are here. So don't listen to all this nonsense about oil money. As Mark said, they're accustomed to fireworks and stuff. Imagine, we haven't received a cent outside of the signing bonus, which was a corrupt disaster. We haven't received a cent because of the production of oil as yet, but we're shooting up fireworks, spending millions of dollars. That is the kind of mentality they have. So understand what is at stake. Comrades, I'm counting on all of you. I'm counting on all of those who over the years have stood with this party, and the young ones too. I'm so pleased that so many young people are coming out now, understanding the message of our party, because you are going to take our legacy forward. You're going to keep this party going and all that it stands for hundreds of years to come, because we believe in Guyana. We love all of this country, and we work hard for our people. Thank you very much, comrades. March 2nd is crucial.